Hi everyone. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the functions of external ear. External ear consists of pinna and ear canal. The functions of external ear can be divided into non-auditory functions and auditory functions. Non-auditory function includes protection mechanism and self-cleaning mechanism, whereas the auditory function includes resonance and localization. Moving on to the non-auditory function of external ear, the ear canal consists of a narrow region called isthmus, the junction between cartilaginous and bony part of the ear canal. This narrow region prevents the entry of any foreign objects into the ear canal. However, if the foreign objects are tiny in nature, it can still enter into the ear canal and damage the tympanic membrane. The skin that covers the bony part of the ear canal is very thin as it is devoid of any glands beneath it. However, the skin layer that covers the cartilaginous portion is thicker with the presence of hair follicles, sebaceous glands and seruminous glands. The sebaceous glands secrete sebum, an oily substance which has antimicrobial function. The seruminous glands secrete wax. Together, these two glands keep the cartilaginous part of the ear canal moist in nature, thereby collecting all the dust particles and microbes. Together, the sebaceous gland neutralizes the microbes or other pathogens, and the seruminous glands create airbags, which will be lodged in the cartilaginous part of the ear canal. The ciliary function of the hair follicles push the airbags towards the external auditory meatus or the opening of the auditory canal. Once the airbags comes to the opening of the ear canal, it can be manually removed. This is the self-cleaning mechanism of the external auditory canal. Moving on to the auditory function of the external ear, the pinna acts as a funnel, funneling the sounds from the environment into the ear canal. By doing so, it collects the energy from a larger area and directing it towards a smaller area of the opening of ear canal. Hence, the pinna concha at the level of external auditory meatus is going to enhance the sound energy at the tympanic membrane in a frequency sensitive way, which means certain frequencies are going to be enhanced. This enhancement is called as resonance. The resonance of pinna varies depending upon the direction of the sound source. The pinna has concha, which is going to collect the sound energy and direct it towards the ear canal. Because of its volume, the resonance frequency of concha ranges between 5 to 6 kHz, and it enhances the sound energy within this frequency range by 10 decibels. Pinna also has various depressions causing a resonance effect. The pinna's resonance comes around 4 kHz and this resonance enhances the energy by 3 decibels. The various ridges and depressions on the pinna is going to filter the sounds, especially at higher frequencies. By doing so, it is going to help in localizing the sound. Pinna helps in localization of sound source at the vertical plane or elevation plane. Also, it helps in localization of sounds between front and back. This image gives us an idea how the pinna is going to filter the high frequency sounds, thereby helping in localization. So when a sound comes from front, it lacks high frequency energy. But if the same sound that is going to come from above, it will have some amount of high frequency energy. This difference is going to give us a clue that the sound source is varying. Moving on to the functions of the ear canal, the auditory canal acts as an closed organ pipe, open on one side and closed on other side. So for any closed organ pipe, the resonant frequency can be calculated using the formula velocity of sound in ear divided by 4 times the length of the pipe. Here, external auditory canal. By doing this calculation, an average ear canal's resonance comes around 2.5 kHz to 2.7 kHz. the amount of enhancement within this frequency range is going to be 13 decibels. The resonance of pinna and air canal is going to contribute for the overall enhancement of sound energy that enters into the air canal or that reaches the tympanic membrane. The resonance of air canal comes around 2.5 to 2.7 kHz and the resonance of concha is going to come around 5 to 6 kHz. Pinna is somewhere around 4 kHz. Now the ear is mounted on the head. So the head shadow effect also helps in enhancing certain frequencies. So this is the resonance of the head. Now together the overall resonance is going to be in this particular aspect where it has two major peaks, one at the resonance of ear canal and one at the resonance of concha. This total resonance is also known as head related transfer function. This head related transfer function can vary depending upon the sound source. In this example, there are two loudspeakers on right side and left side. So when the right loudspeaker is going to generate energy or sound, the closer ear, which is the right ear, is going to have a head related transfer function like this. It receives sound at a higher energy level. Whereas the farther ear, the left ear, is going to receive similar kind of energy but at lower levels. So this difference is going to help us to localize the sound in the horizontal plane. Hence, the resonance is going to help in localizing the sound. These are the references used for this particular lecture. Thank you.